everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a double integrals problem. And the one that we're going to be dealing with is the integral from 0 to 3 of the integral from 0 to 3 again of xy plus 7x plus y dx dy. So the first thing that we should look at is the order in which our dx dy appears. Sometimes you have dx and then dy. Sometimes you have dy and then dx. What we care about is recognizing that dx is going to match this inside integral over here from 0 to 3. And then we've got an outer integral from 0 to 3 that relates to dy. And basically what these brackets tell us is that we always want to work from the inside out. So first, because dx is on the inside, we're going to be taking the integral with respect to x first from 0 to 3 based on this inner integral here. Limits of integration. And then once we're done with that and we've plugged in our limits of integration and simplified as much as we can, then we'll be taking the integral with respect to y from 0 to 3 based on the outer integral. So in order to take the integral of xy plus 7x plus y with respect to x, we'll be treating y as a constant. So in our case here, let's go ahead and write the outer integral. I'm writing down this one, 0 to 3, because we're going to leave that alone for now. But then I'm going to draw a big bracket and take the integral of everything inside here. So the integral of xy, first of all, we recognize that y will be treated like a constant on the x variable. So this is basically this first term, xy. When we're taking the integral of that with respect to x and holding y constant, it's basically the same thing as saying that we're taking the integral of something like 4x, right? With y as a constant, it becomes the coefficient on the x term, just like 4x. And if we were going to take the integral of 4x, we would get 4 over 2x squared, right? Well, same thing here. We're going to divide by 2 and the coefficient, and then we're going to square the x term. And we're just going to leave the y because the 4 stays right where it is, right? It's the same thing. So the y is going to stay right where it is. So it's 1 half x squared y. The integral of 7x with respect to x is easy because there's no y involved. So that's just going to be 7 halves x squared. And then the integral with respect to y, well, imagine if you're taking a regular integral with only x variables, whatever, and you've got the integral of 4. Well, the integral of that is going to be 4x. You just tack on that variable because this is a constant, then you add the variable, that's the integral. So similarly here, y is just like our constant 4, so we're just going to add the x term to it, and the integral will be xy. So that's our integral with respect to x, but we have to evaluate from 0 to 3 based on these inner limits of integration. And then we're still going to have to integrate with respect to y later. But for now, let's go ahead and simplify what we just did with the integral with respect to x. So we'll plug in our limits of integration. We'll get 1 half. And the thing to note is because we just took the integral with respect to x, we're going to be plugging in 4x and leaving y as it is. So we'll plug in 3 for x and leave y right where it is. So plus 7 halves times 3 squared plus 3y. And then we'll subtract from that what we get when we plug in 0. So 1 half times 0 squared times y plus 7 halves times 0 squared plus 0y, and then dy here. Okay, so if we simplify this, 3 squared is 9, so that'll give us 9 halves y, and then 3 squared again is 9 times 7 is 63, so plus 63 halves plus 3y, and then this term is going to cancel to 0, this will be 0, and this will be 0, because everything's multiplied by 0, so that's it, and then we go ahead and write our dy, and this is essentially as simple as we can get this integral here that we took with respect to x. So now that we've simplified as much as we can go ahead and take the integral with respect to y. So taking the integral with respect to y, let's see, we'll get, y squared, and then we'd get 9 halves divided by 2, which will be 9 fourths. So 9 fourths y squared, and then 63 over 2, well, we would just add the y variable to that, because the integral of a constant is just that constant plus the variable. And then the integral of 3y will be, oh, I guess we could have stuck that with our 9 halves y, but it's totally fine. So we'll get 3 halves y squared, and now we want to evaluate that on the range 0 to 3. So that's our integral with respect to y, and now it's just a matter of plugging in our limits of integration for y. And we don't have any x variables left, but if we did, we would do the same thing. We would just plug in for y and leave x as it was. So we'll plug in for y here. Let's actually go ahead and combine these y terms here. So if we multiply this last term by 2 over 2, right, we would get 6 over 4, 6 fourths. So 6 fourths plus 9 fourths will be 15 fourths y squared plus 63 halves y on the range 0 to 3. Okay, so now we can very easily plug in our limits of integration. So, yeah, that's right, okay. So 15 fourths times 3 squared plus 63 halves times 3. And then we'll subtract from that what we get when we plug in 0. So 15 fourths times 0 squared plus 63 halves times 0. And that's it. So again, 3 squared will give us 9. 9 times 15 is 90 and 45, 135. So we'll get 135 over 4. 63 times 3 would be 189, so plus 189 over 2. And then this will go to 0 and this will go to 0. So let's go ahead and multiply this second term by 2 over 2 so that we can get a common denominator. So we'll get 135 over 4 plus 189 times 2 is going to be 378. So 378 over 4. And when we add those together, we'll get 513 fourths. So that's it. I don't think you can simplify 513 fourths. But again, we took the integral with respect to x, plugged in our inner limits of integration, 0 to 3, simplified that as much as we could, and then took the integral with respect to y, evaluated again on those outer limits of integration, and were able to simplify to our final answer of 513 over 4. So I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!